Good morning, my dear children. How are you all? Hope you all will be fine. Last class we have finished lesson 1. Now we are moving on to lesson 2. The name of the lesson is More on Windows 7. Lesson 2, More on Windows 7. Basically, Windows 7 is one of the commonly used operating system. Now we will see what is an operating system. Operating system acts as an interface between the user and the computer hardware. See, operating system acts as an interface between the user, between us, that is, we are the users. So, between us and the computer hardware, that is, it acts like a middleman between the user and the computer hardware. Then, it enables communication between the application software and the hardware. So it enables the communication between the application software and hardware. See, this picture tells about this point. Only with the help of operating system, the communication between the application software and the hardware is done. So only the operating system passes the messages to the application software from the hardware and from the application software to the hardware. Children, usually for any operating system, the first screen that appears on the computer after you switch on is desktop. Desktop is the main interface and the default location for the programs and documents. It is the main interface and it is the default locations where most of the programs and documents will be saved. Files, folders and programs icons can be found on the desktop. We can see the icons of files, folders and programs. Icons means small graphical images or symbols. At the bottom of the desktop, we can see the taskbar. The taskbar consists of start menu. This is quick launch area. This is notification area. And this is show desktop button. Start menu. On clicking on start menu, we can move to any of the programs. Quick launch area is used to display the programs that we opened currently. Notification area is used to display the time and date and other type of notifications. Show desktop button. On pressing on show desktop button, we can come directly to the desktop from any other screen. Children, this is the picture of desktop. This is the first screen that appears on the computer system. After you switch on your computer, these are the icons that are available on the desktop. And this is the taskbar available at the bottom of the desktop. Clear with it, children? Children, now we'll move on to the functions of an operating system. See, children, these are all the functions of the operating system. First one, loading and execution, memory management, device management, processor management, file management, and the last one is security. First, loading and execution. It loads programs and then executes them. First, the program will be loaded into the computer and then it will be executed. If you want to open any one of the file will be first loaded into your computer and then it will be opened. Okay. Then memory management. It manages memory within the computer. If you want to store a file in some specific area, there should be memory. So that memory will be managed by the operating system. Okay. Then device management. It controls all the peripheral devices like keyboard, mouse and so on attached to the computer with the help of software called device drivers. Now the devices that are attached to the computer are managed by the operating system. The functions of all these devices like keyboard, mouse, etc. are managed by the operating system. Then processor management. It manages and prioritizes tasks for the CPU when there are many tasks. When there are many tasks, the CPU will give priority to each and every task. For example, first priority task will be executed first, and then the second priority, and then the other priority task will be get executed. That priority will be given by the operating system. Then file management. It manages disk space, files and folders. If you are deleting a file from your computer, that disk space should be there. That space should be get free by the operating system. Okay, then security. It protects the data stored in the computer. The operating system protect all your data that are stored in the computer. It won't get deleted or it won't get affected by any harmful virus. Okay, these are all the functions of an operating system. Understood, children? Next, we are going to see about control panel. See, what is the use of control panel? Control panel is used to adjust your computer settings. If you want to make changes in your computer settings, you should go to control panel and change it. How to go to control panel? We can open control panel by clicking on start and then go to the option control panel. It opens category views by default. See, this is the picture of control panel. It opened the category view. See, this is the category view of control panel. To change icons view, click on view by option. If you want to change this view, you can go to this view by option and change it. Now we can see how to open the control panel in our system. See, go to start, go click on control panel. See, it opened adjust your computer settings. It opened with the category view. For changing the views of the icons, you should go to this view by and then change it. If you want to change into large icons, it will be changed like this. Or small icons, it will be viewed like this. Or category, this is the category view. Understood, children? Now we will learn how to change the date and time in your system. See, there are two ways for changing date and time settings. First, you should go to start, click on control panel, then click on clock, language and region, then go to set the time and date, then go to change date and time. See, this is the first way to change the date and time setting. After going there, you should click on the arrows to change the time on the computer. Click OK to save changes. Okay, we can use arrows to change the time and then click OK. See, now we are going to change the time in our computer. See, this is the time now. Now we are going to change the time. For that, go to start, go to control panel, then click on clock, region, language and region. See, this is here. Now go to date and time. See, date and time dialog box opened. Now you should go to change date and time. In change date and time, we can use these arrows to change the date, to change the time. See, with the help of these arrows, we can change the time. It will change in the clock. Okay, see, now I have changed to this time and I am also changing the date. Now I have changed to August 12. Okay, click on okay to save the changes, and then click on okay. See, now the time has been changed to 7:51 and August 12. Understood, children? Now there is another way to change the setting. Right click on date or time display, then go to adjust date or time, change the date and time. Okay, first we have to right click on it. We can see that now. See, right click on date or time, adjust date or time, go to adjust date or time. See, date and time dialog box will be appearing. Follow the same old steps. Go to change date and time, then use the arrows to keep the time. Now I am going to keep 12:52. Okay, then date is November 18. Okay, now I have changed to the date and time. Click on OK to save changes and click OK. See, now the old date and time came. This is correct date and time. We have changed the date and time in the second way also. Using the second way also, we have changed the date and time. Now understood, children? These green color text are the two ways to change the date and time settings in your computer. Understood, children? Children, now we are going to change the mouse settings. For that, we have to open the mouse properties window. Now we will see how to open the mouse properties window. First of all, open the mouse properties window by going to control panel and click on hardware and sound. Under devices and printers, click on mouse. Mouse properties window opens. See, this is the picture of mouse properties window. Okay, what we should go and do there, now we will see here. See, under buttons tab and pointers tab we are going to work. What we should do with the buttons tab? See, to interchange the functions of the right click and the left click button, buttons tab is used to interchange the functions of right click and left click button. See, for left click we will use select by left clicking it, and will open, delete, rename, they will come when we right click on it. So we are going to interchange the function of left click and right click. If we want to select, we are going to do right click, and if we want to open or delete a file, we are going to left click it. For that, we should go to buttons tab, then go to button configuration, and then switch primary and secondary buttons. You have to tick the checkbox of switch primary and secondary buttons. Now the functions of the left click and the right click will be changed. We can also change the speed of double click. Double click means making click two times continuously. Okay, in the buttons tab, under double click speed, drag the slider to increase or decrease the speed. We can drag the slider to increase or decrease the speed of the double click. Then pointers tab. We saw the buttons tab, now pointers tab. Pointers tab to change the style of the mouse pointer. See, this is the mouse pointer, this arrow. Arrow is the mouse pointer. We can change the style of the arrow. For that, we should go to printers, pointers tab, then go to scheme. Choose the type of the pointer and click OK to save all the changes. Go to pointers tab, then go to scheme. Then you want to choose the mouse pointer that you want and click on OK to save all the changes. Now I am going to show how to change the mouse properties. For that, first we have to open the control panel. Go to start control panel, Then we should go to hardware and sound. Where is hardware and sound? Here it is. Hardware and sound. Under hardware and sound, we should see for devices and printers. See, here it is, devices and printers. Under devices and printers, we have to move to mouse. Mouse properties window will be opened. There we can change the speed of the double click, and we can change the function of the primary and secondary buttons. Okay, if we check this checkbox, the primary and the secondary buttons functions will be interchanged. Then we can make this slider for the drag this slider for changing the double click. We can change the double click by dragging this slider. Understood? This is the work we should do in buttons tab. Then in pointers tab, okay, first we have to then we have to click OK to save all the changes. Okay, then for pointers tab, we have to go to pointers tab and select any one of the arrow that you want. See, many arrows are there. If you are selecting like this one and click OK, then the arrow will be changed. Children, we saw changing mouse settings. Now we are going to see how to change the sound settings. We are going to see the changes that will be done in the speakers. For that, we should go to control panel, then go to hardware and sound, then click on sound. Under the playback tab, we should go to speakers. After that, speakers properties dialog box will be opened. Under levels tab, click on levels tab, then adjust the sound volume using the slider and then click OK. This is one way, and the very easier way is making changes in the taskbar. In the speakers icon that is available in the taskbar, adjust the sound volume and then click OK. Now we are going to see how to change the sound settings in our computer. For that, go to control panel, click on hardware and sound, go to the option sound, that is link sound. Under playback tab, go to speakers and then click on properties. See, speakers properties dialog box is opened. Now we can do the changes that we want here. For that, we should go to the levels tab, then we can change the volume of the speaker using this slider. Okay, understood children? For saving all these changes, click on OK. This is the way to change your speaker settings, sound settings. Okay, then click on OK. Or otherwise, you can just go to this taskbar, the speaker icon available in the taskbar, click on it and then make changes using the slider available in the speaker icon. Understood children? This is one of the easier way to make changes in the sound settings. Now we will see how to change the sound settings for the microphones that are connected to the computer. See, first we have to go to control panel, then hardware and sound, then go to sound. Under the recording tab, click on microphone and click on properties button. Microphone properties dialog box will be opened. Then click on levels tab and make the changes there, and then click on OK to save all the changes. See, now I am going to change the properties of microphone. For that, we should go to control panel, go to hardware and sound. The hardware and sound, go to the link sound. Under recordings tab, go to microphone. Click on microphone. If the microphone is connected, it will show green color symbol here, but microphone is not connected in my system. Go to properties, make the changes that you want. If the microphone is connected, you can change the volume with the help of slider, and then click OK to save changes. Here also you should click OK. Now the changes that you have made will be set in your computer. Okay, understood children? The next one we are going to see is how to change the desktop background, the background image that is in the desktop. How to change that image? There are two ways to change that image. First way is go to control panel, then go to appearance and personalization, then make changes under each tab. Under each tab you can make any of the changes. For example, you can select the background, select background tab and change the image. It will automatically change the background of your desktop. Okay, this is the first method. First we'll do the first method. For that we have to go to control panel, then click on appearance and personalization. See, under under that we should go to personalization. See, under each tab we can do any changes that we want. For example, under background tab we are going to change the background of your desktop. This is the background of your desktop now because there is a tick mark. Now we are going to change the background of the desktop. For example, we'll change this one. Now this is selected and we have to deselect it. This is selected, then save changes. Close it to see the new desktop background. See, this is the first way to change your desktop background. Now the next way is right click on desktop, then go to properties and then go to personalize. Under each tab you can select and make changes. See, right click on desktop, properties and personalize. Now we'll do that. Right click on the desktop, go to under properties, we can go to personalize. Okay, now the same tab is opened. You can go to desktop background and select any of the pictures you want. I'm deselecting this one and selecting this picture and go to save changes. To save all the changes, now the desktop background is changed. See, these are the two ways to change the background of your desktop. We went to personalize option and we changed the background of your desktop. Understood children? You can also change the image that you want, any of the image that you want, to set the background of your desktop. See children, now we are going to see about an interesting software called Windows Media Player. We'll see what is Windows Media Player. This is the icon for Windows Media Player. See, Windows Media Player can be used for viewing photos, videos, listening to music stored on your hard disk, or using any other media device like a CD player attached to your computer. So Windows Media Player, otherwise called WMP, it is used to view photos, listen music and view videos from your computer or any other CD player in your computer. Then you can also use to rip audio CDs and organize music collection on the disk. If you want to copy the audio, copy from the audio CDs, we can use this. Or if you want to arrange any music collection, we can use this software. It supports almost all the audio formats like MP3, WMA, WAV and video formats like AVI and MPEG4. See, these are all the audio formats that are supported by the Windows Media Player, and these are the video formats that are supported by the WMP. How to go to Windows Media Player? We should use Start button and then we should click on Windows Media Player. After going to that, we can play any video or listen music or view any photo. Now we'll see how to go to Windows Media Player. For that, we should go to Start button, then search for Windows Media Player. See, it is displaying here. Go to Windows Media Player, then you can view any of the photo or videos with the help of this tab. See, now I'm going to play this video, right? Double click on it to play this video. See, with the help of this Windows Media Player, we are playing a video and seeing that. Okay, understood the use of Windows Media Player? Children, now we are going to see how to play a music CD. For that, we have to open Windows Media Player. Now I showed how to go to Windows Media Player. Like that, we should open Windows Media Player. Then open the CD drive of your computer. In your computer, CD drive will be available. Go to that and open it. Place the music CD in the disk tray and close it. In your CPU, there will be a disk tray to place the CD. Place your music CD in that disk tray. The CD will automatically start playing in Windows Media Player. If you go to that video and double click on it, that CD will be playing in the Windows Media Player. You can try this in your computer also. Next, we are going to see how to rip a music CD. Rip means copy. See, first we will see what is meant by ripping. Copying music, pictures and videos from an audio CD or DVD to your PC. PC means personal computer, that is our computer. See, first we have to copy music, pictures and videos. We have to copy any music or pictures or videos from CD or DVD, and then we are going to paste it in your personal computer. This is called ripping. For that, how we should do? Place the music CD in the disk tray and close it. We have to place the music CD in the disk tray available in your CPU and close it. And select the songs and click on Rip CD button. Select the songs that you want to rip and click on Rip CD button. The songs get ripped, that is copied to the Windows Media Player library. The songs that are available on the CD will be now available in the Windows Media Player library, so that you can play in your system itself. We do not want to go to that CD or DVD all the time. Okay, now we are going to see how to burn data to CD, that is copy data to CD. Ripping is we are getting data from CD and copying it to the computer. This one, getting data from computer and copying it to your CD. Now we will see what is burning. Burning means copying music, pictures and videos to a blank CD or DVD is called burning. From your computer, you are going to copy music or picture or videos to your CD, blank CD, that is empty CD, that is available in your disk tray. We are going to copy these music, pictures, and this is called burning. How to do burning? Place the music CD in the disk tray and close it. We have to place the music CD available in the CPU and close it. Autoplay dialog box appears. Autoplay dialog box will be appeared. Click on burn files to disk. See, click on this option, burn files to disk. Then burn a disk dialog box will appear. There will be a dialog box called burn a disk. Click on next. See, next, you should click on next. an empty folder appears. Drag all the files to this folder you wish to copy from the computer to CD. An empty folder will appear after clicking on next, and then you should drag the files or folders that you want to copy to the CD. Then at last you should click on burn to disk. Click on burn to disk and you should follow some of the simple steps that the wizard tells you to follow. This is the way to burn data to CD. Understood, children? Children, now we came to our final session, that is giving home assignment. You should do this home assignment at your home. The home assignment is fill the book bag exercises in your computer science book and write the question answers in your computer science note neatly. You should fill the book bag exercises in your computer science book. For that, I'll send the PDF. Seeing that PDF, you should write it neatly. Then write the question answers in your computer science note. In your computer science note, you should write the question answers. That will also be sent with the PDF itself. You should write both these neatly and complete your book bag exercises and your classwork note. And thanks for watching. Thank you.